Hello, greetings. This is Gilles Mancier. I thought I'd come and say hello. Wish you a good day, for we are really moving towards something completely new. I hope you do sense already that the new energies, your guidance, your inspiration, that for the spirit is when you connected to a higher self. Your higher self always shows you about your future, but then sometimes you want to be there already, but it just shows you a direction of what is ahead, and so it's about being attuned. I wanted to say that a lot of people I see in the world are very blocked within religious dogmas. They believe that their religion is the truth, and everybody that doesn't believe like them will go to hell. And when the veils of truth will fall, those people, they put themselves in such a high pedestal that they will fall from very high, because all their beliefs are complete illusion, for God does not judge, he loves. And so it is like in the Inquisition, at the time of the Inquisition, people were put to death because they didn't agree with those dogmas. And those were direction, they were not end in itself. All the religious revelations are direction for hell, to assist man towards elevating his consciousness. But now we have to evolve and follow the inner presence, the presence of God, that is love. For we cannot see in the world what's really going on, who's white hat, the black hats, who's pulling the strings, until the full disclosure will come. This will come, and then we'll know. For all many things in the world has been created for indoctrination, to maintain the fear, to be submissive to some outer forces, so they can continue this Orwellian program. And there's been great prejudice that were taught against the ascended master, the higher community of higher beings. For the Christ is just one of them, but they are all the ascended master have different wisdom, and they serve in different capacities, just as the extraterrestrial is an extra-dimensional. For if there is darkness that is coming, they will not come from the sky, it comes from below. And those that came from below are already in incarnation for a very long time, yet their power is waning. And so what we want to do is to empower ourselves through the power of the Christ, but also through the power of the Archangel Michael. We want to become one with those forces, one with those, but we want to bless through the Christ. We can utilize all the energies of the ascended realm to utilize for the 11-11 stargates. I was mentioning that there is those four archangels that will assist us in bringing our pillar of light and the great I Am presence with this tube of light that will assist us in elevating. Ask your I Am presence to create this tube of light for yourself so you can ascend your consciousness. And there is all many, many other archangels and ascended masters that are standing at the gate behind 11-11. And you can call on them whenever you're familiar, and then you start to recognize them. You may not be able to see them physically yet, if your third eye is not open enough, but you will be able to begin to sense the difference of frequency and vibration between the archangels. So it is good to work with all those spirits. And yet when we call on the source, the creator, what we call God, the prime creator, the origin and destiny of all that is, then we englobe all things and all being. We do not, that's the only way we know that everybody's included. So it's about utilizing those resources. We want to bless through the Christ, and we want to transmute, to prepare the golden age through the violet fire of Saint-Germain. And so, we also want to know that you are the God in you. I am the God in me. I am that I am. And we're going to be able to resurrect our four lower bodies, physical body, our mental body, our emotional body, and astral body. They will come into alignment, and then we'll ignite the spirit, also spiritual bodies. We're here to prepare the golden age. We want to set peace and goodwill upon men. And the reason why peace and goodwill upon men is not being set up is not because of humanity. It's because of those dark souls that have incarnated and are pulling the strings to prevent this peace from happening. But it is their power is diminishing each and every day. It's like the sun of the light of truth is melting the snow, and the snow has no choice but to melt, and so those powers will disappear as more light workers return to their own self and empowered self. So it is good to invoke many presence, but to to still remain conscious of that one source that is the source of all that is, and understand the all the ascended masters are working through the office of the Christ. It's all in unity. For some people, it was they believe that only the Christ is divine, is the only child of God, and then everybody else is like bound to go to hell. It's like complete insanity that was created by the dark forces to indoctrinate humanity to stay in darkness. For we are all children of God, and we follow that line that has been set by the Christ back to the source. So the dark ones will not come from above, and there is no fear, will not be invaded by dark extraterrestrials. They're already here and controlling the matrix from below. So it is like whatever comes from the skies will be blessed and come from heaven. So I also wanted to say that it's much easier to connect to your spirit and to spirit and higher forces when we are in nature, when we feel the energies of the trees. They're all very personal. They have different energies of the grass, of the dirt, of the sea, of the river, of the flowers, of the birds, of everything. It really assists us in connecting, and this is through those, once we are in non-resistance in this connection to nature, that spirits can communicate, or even extraterrestrials or ascended masters or angelics, and do as much you can to bring more nature into your home, like flowers and plants and crystals. Those are of great assistance to us, and eventually we're going to bring more nature into the cities. The problem, the pollution of the cities right now, is like nature has been forgotten in galactic cities. There is nature is completely omnipresent within the cities, and there is water running through all the houses in the walls and everywhere. There's running water everywhere, and it's like we will come to evolve this art of civilization in time. For what we want is to bring peace and prosperity. It was something that was given to everybody during the Golden Age. And we are children of the sun. We have to awaken. We awaken the tribe of blue fire. We are the tribe of blue fire. And so the Archangel Michael is the leader in that process. He's one of the major archangels that guides you, protects humanity since it's fallen into darkness. For our task is to prepare the Golden Age, and the past is being healed, so we're going to be able to move into the now, move into the heart, to the now of the One. In the past Golden Age, there was no question that all was one and all was love, and everybody was deserving of this abundance. So when you go to sleep at night, recognize this oneness, this unity with the whole cosmos and all that is. And then when you wake up in the morning with that knowledge, and then do your best to live throughout your day in improving this connection to the unity of things. For once you become master once we become master of our own screenplay, we are the lead actor in our life. We are the main role, but we dictate somewhat the response of everybody else. Everybody else fulfill this karmic relationship in relationship to our own situation and position. When we move into ascension, everybody will move into this ascension with us to mirror that as well. I wanted to say it's good to do yoga and to do stretching, to do posture, so we can move the energy, or to exercise, so the energy is able to find drink a lot of water as well, and understanding also that the soul is androgynous. Originally we were created perfect divine soul, and we choose to incarnate as male or female form, and it's like so male and female. There's no separation in higher society between male and female. This is a choice of personification. At some time and point we choose to embody female or male, but there is they're both divine and equal and complementary. There is a great deal of in this world that right now a woman asking for similar pay for similar work. It is absolutely normal that the woman to be equal to men. It's just like it took a long time for that to come into balance and alignment. But so the highest wisdom for us today is finance. What we need to understand is the Amerindian. what we need to do is forgiveness. And the outcome is the monk or the nun, which means to not to disperse our energy, but to be open and free as well, not to be limited by any past vows that we could have taken in monasteries in past lives as well. So I hope you find this message interesting. I'm going to pull one more card with the archangels. I'm going to sing a song. And the paintings behind me is this is a painting on paper that I've never shown before. It's like in the Saint-Exupéry, the Petit Prince. They're like small planets. There is those three small planets, and this on the bottom is the one is the Earth. And on the Earth, there is this easel that's like standing above, and it's got this whole dark center. So it's all being cleansed. And very close by, there is another easel with another planet, the symbol of peace. And here there is another green planet with like an ascended master, and then the symbol of Victoria, the goddess, and the planet Victoria. And this is this is nearly complete. I completed Saturn here. I think it's quite beautiful, and it really works. It's just this area. I'm not really sure if I need to do something. It's very maybe Uranus. Maybe I can do something more. I'm not really sure. I'm going very slow on that. Those are very. I'm doing paintings of subjects that have already been treated, like portraits and scenes and nudes and things like that. I enjoy to do that. But I have certain very specific scenes that have never been touched in all of art history, such as astronomy. This is like hundreds of symbols and names of planets, and those have never been touched by anyone in the whole of art history. So people like or may not like it. It's just personal. But I will continue to return to those cosmic and metacosmic and spiritual and cosmology and divinity. Those subjects are highly personal, but because they're so personal, they're very hard to introduce into the world because they come from very deep. They're very deep. And so, but I enjoy to do, I've started some painting. I'm starting a Mona Lisa, Gioconda. It's a painting. It will take a long time. I started a painting, a tribute to Velázquez called Les Ménines. So on canvas, those are tributes to other great artists. So I'm going to sing this song and pull one more card. It's a song that went through my head. I have to sing it because if I don't sing it, it will continue to go through my head. It's the only way for me to move beyond that. It's a song of David Bowie. It's called The Man Who Sold the World. We passed upon the stairs, we spoke of what and when. Although I wasn't there, he said I was his friend, which came as a surprise. I spoke into his eyes, I thought you died alone. A long, long time ago. Oh no, not me. We never lost control. You face to face with a man who sold the world. Dum do 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 dum do 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 dum do 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 dum. I laughed and shook his hand and made my way back home. I searched for form and land. For years and years I roam. I gaze a gazeless stare and walk a million hills. I must have died alone. A long, long time ago. Who knows? Not me. I never lost control. Your face to face with the man who sold the world. Who knows? Not me. I never lost control. Your face to face with the man who sold the world. Voilà, thank you very much. Thank you for liking, sharing, commenting, subscribing. We'll put one more card. It's a song I looked on YouTube. The most popular version is from the singer of Nirvana. it's the song of David Bowie was very, very advanced, very cosmic, because all his songs are very cosmic, very very forward. He's like the ultimate rebel, right? He was very rebellious in his life, David Bowie. And we send greetings to him, and we send, as a tribute, we continue to sing his music. The card of the day is the Ten of Ariel, wonderful card. You have so many reasons to be grateful to life. Success on the financial plane. Retirement on the horizon. A rich and gratifying family life. So what else can we ask for? It is all coming, it is all in the work, it is already, it is either there or in the works. So do not doubt a second, be ready, prepare yourself. There is this 11-11 portal that will really shift everything, but shift already and be in the now and allow your past to be healed and enjoy the now as much as possible. I thank you very much. Namaste.